Hi friends, in this video I am going to discuss about RTD tolerance classes defined as per the IEC 60751 standard. RTD stands for Resistance Temperature Detector, and this is widely used sensor in industries for measuring the temperature because of its various advantages. And the basic construction element of an RTD is a metal. The metals are having positive temperature coefficient of resistance, which means the resistance will increase with increase of the temperature, and the change in resistance is used for displaying the temperature. The metals with these properties like high melting point, good corrosion resistance, high resistivity, good long-term stability, high robustness are used for the construction of the RTDs, and the commonly used metals are platinum, nickel and copper. IEC 751 is the universal standard for RTD, and this applies to platinum RTDs with temperature coefficient of resistance of 3850 ppm, which comes to 0.00385 ohm per ohm per degree centigrade, and this is the equation for that. So R100 minus R0 by R0 into 100 degree centigrade, where R100 is the resistance at 100 degree centigrade, where R0 is the resistance at 0 degree centigrade. There are other standards are available for RTDs like GC 1604 1987 version, which applies to platinum RTD with 3916 ppm temperature coefficient of resistance, and later versions of the standard also conforms to IEC 751 standard. And other temperature coefficient of resistance used for platinum RTDs are 3750 ppm and 3770 ppm. Here you can see in this table the class A and class B defined as per this IEC standard and their parameters. So R0 is the resistance at 0 degree centigrade, and for class A it is having plus or minus 0.06%, and for class B it is having plus or minus 0.12%. These are the temperature ranges for these classes. And the temperature tolerance, here we can see this temperature tolerance is not fixed, it increases with increase of the temperature. And this is the table that shows other classes as per IEC 751 standard. So, and their parameters are not and temperature tolerance. And if your application requirement is high accuracy, then you should go for class A or class 1/3B. And if your application requirement is high range, means you are going to measure higher temperatures and accuracy is less, accuracy is also acceptable, then you can go for class B and class 2B. The tolerance nomenclature for RTD temperature sensing element were revised in the later versions, that is IEC 60751, 2008, 7 and later versions, they are revised. Here you can see old tolerance class is class 1/3B, and new tolerance class is replaced by this designation, where star indicates F or W. F stands for thin film and W stands for wire wound type RTD. Here I am considering thin film type RTD. Then this new designation is class F.1, and for class A it is class F.15. This is the basically the temperature tolerance, and class B is class F.3, class 2B is class F.6. Here you can see the table for class A and class B for temperature versus the temperature tolerance. So with increase of the temperature, so you can see the error is also increasing. And this is the graph that shows the temperature versus tolerance for class A and class B. So for applications with good accuracy, you can go for class A, but the temperature range is limited. And here you can see for higher ranges you can go for class B, but their accuracy is poor. And this is the table showing the resistance tolerances for different classes, that is class A and class B, in terms of the temperature. So this resistance here you can see class B is increasing with increase of the temperature. And this is the graph that shows the resistance tolerances versus the temperature. And this is the equation. This is simplified model for resistance and temperature relationship for the RTDs, where RT is the resistance at a particular temperature, where R0 is the resistance at 0 degree centigrade, where alpha is the temperature coefficient of resistance, and this platinum RTD as per IEC 60751 standard is 0.00385. So for getting accurate results, so the temperature resistance relationship of RTD is given by Callender Van Dusen. So as per this, so the equation is given by RT equal to R0 into 1 plus AT plus BT square plus C into T minus 100 into T cube. So this is for temperatures less than 0 degree centigrade. So on this Callender Van Dusen equation gives more accurate relationship between the temperature and the resistance, where A, B, C are constants and it depends upon the curve, means for different temperature coefficient of resistance, so these A, B, C constants will vary, and for temperature above 0 degree centigrade, so this is the equation, the C becomes 0, then the equation is given by RT equal to R0 into 1 plus AT plus BT square. So as per this IEC 60751 standard, so for 3850 ppm temperature coefficient of resistance, the Callender Van Dusen parameters, that is constants, are given by A equal to 3.9083 into 10 power minus 3, and these are the B and C values. And here I am discussing an example, so which shows the use of this Callender Van Dusen equation for getting the temperature and resistance relationship. So here you can see the resistance of RTD is 100 ohms at 0 degree centigrade. We are having this value, and if A and B are constants for this TC 3850, that is temperature coefficient of resistance of 3850 ppm, so then we need to calculate the temperature when the resistance is showing 138 ohms, because the change in the resistance is calculated by this signal conditioning circuit. This 138 ohms is measured by the signal conditioning circuit, then it should be converted to temperature. So by using this equation, it can be converted more accurately to temperature. So here we know that 138 is the new resistance, and this is the initial resistance 100, 1 plus AT plus BT squared. A and B are the constants, we know these values, and this is equation we are getting, BT square plus AT minus 0.38. this is basically a quadratic equation. If you see a quadratic equation of AX square plus BX plus C, their solution is given by minus B plus or minus square root of B square minus 4AC by 2A. So same here, you derived for this temperature values, so minus A plus or minus A square minus 4B into this is the constant by 2B. And if you solve this equation, we are getting, that is the temperature corresponding to 138 ohm is 98.615 degree centigrade. And if you put that resistance as 138.5, so we will get T as 100 degree centigrade. So at 100 degree centigrade, so the resistance is 138.5 ohms. Thank you for watching my video.